The very simple answer for Bittensor is, what if we took that immense amount of compute, which is equivalent to somewhere between 100 to 200 terawatt hours, which is somewhere between 12 to 24 nuclear power stations of energy to supply it, which is about the energy use of a mid-sized European country. And what if we used all of that work for the creation and provision of intelligence? What if you combine these two elements of the demand for intelligence and the market organizing forces of blockchains together?
Get right down to it. Bittensor is an incentive alignment engine. Just abstract everything else away, that's what it is.
The supercomputer in the world, which was Bitcoin. It's a thermodynamic computer. It's just using an abstract representation of thermodynamics, which is money, and stitches together all of these resources. So I thought, hey, well, we can do that. We can do that for artificial intelligence. Let's try to do that.
I don't want to have to pick five AI tokens and hope I got it right. I want to own the entire ecosystem that forces quality to rise to the top. Bittensor's competitive mining mechanism is exactly what crypto was supposed to be. Incentive alignment that produces real value, not just speculation. But let's talk about Bittensor and what it means for me, my thesis, where I think it's headed. Be sure to let me know in the comments how you feel about Bittensor and TAO. But before we go further, here's a word from the sponsors of the video. Your TAO deserves a wallet built by the people who created Bittensor. Crucible is the only TAO native wallet with ledger integration built by Bittensor's founding engineers. Stake, allocate, track your P&L, and even transfer all in one place. See your alpha positions across subnets and use the smart allocator to put your rewards to work automatically. All your TAO in one place. Get Crucible in the link in the description.
Warren Buffett top blessed. He's usually a contrarian investor, so it was kind of crazy to see him say, hey, I'm all in on AI. That brings me to the next point of this video, when Bittensor clicked for me. Bittensor really clicked for me when I started to research the infrastructure layers of artificial intelligence. Data, compute, prediction markets, and robotics. I didn't want to kind of spread myself thin by having all of these cryptocurrencies. So when DTAO came around and I started doing research on a lot of these subnets are doing the same thing as some of these crypto tokens. The only difference, in my opinion, is they're delivering quality. The research on these subnets and more so into these, you know, layers throughout artificial intelligence. I told you guys how when I'm riding on the highway, I'm starting to see so much surveillance, right? Cameras, which made me do research into stuff like automatic license plate readers, right? And how it will need this data. And I started like doing more research on drones and how drones will be utilizing data and how physical robots will be utilizing data, and kind of got down the rabbit hole of spatial data. You know, your keyword, you keep hearing me say data. The problem is that anything that you do right now, it doesn't matter if it's on your phone, on your computer, or even while you're driving, you're delivering data to centralized entities for free. So that's another thing that kind of like caught my attention about Bittensor, because they offer all of these avenues and gateway opportunities to be incentivized for your contributions to artificial intelligence, for your contributions to the AI economy. And when you take a deep dive into things like prediction markets, robotics, compute, I mean, all of this stuff has one thing in common. They live off data. And in order for this artificial intelligence to be able to refine this data, it needs electricity, which is compute. So those are kind of like the pillars, right? And then everything else just makes sense, right? Think about prediction markets. Well, you can't have a prediction market without data. Right, you can't have robots without data. You can't have artificial intelligence without data. You can't have none of this stuff without compute. If you ever build anything, you build anything online utilizing artificial intelligence, you need compute. And then you got these subnets that allow you seamlessly to be able to contribute to artificial intelligence by simply training AI models in a decentralized way. I think it's subnet 9 iota. They'll be dropping a way that you can actually mine a TAO by training AI models. This is the kind of things that you can do on Bittensor. If you have any, you know, experience in coding, developing, if you're an indie developer, you got an idea, it just makes sense to work on top of Bittensor. It just makes sense, in my opinion, to build on top of Bittensor. So, you know, when I think about Bittensor as an investment, okay, I'm like, artificial intelligence is going to be huge. It's literally not going anywhere. We've literally never seen Warren Buffett top blast, and he top blasted AI. And then you got these crazy tokenomics where Bittensor has a halving, it has scarcity, it has the same tokenomics as Bitcoin, and Bitcoin is literally sitting at over $100,000. So think about that for a second, right? AI is one of the fastest growing tech asset, whatever you want to call it. And then right at that cross intersection, you got Bitcoin's tokenomics. Regardless of where Bittensor goes from here on out, right, whether it goes into a bear market or whether we just have this liquidity tsunami that comes in, I think it's set up to do very, very well in the next 2 to 5 years. Now, one of the things I want to talk about is TaoFlow. Now, this is not a bullish or bearish take, or, you know, I'm not on the people who like TaoFlow side, the people who don't like TaoFlow side, but I want to explain it to the community in a way that everybody can understand. Bittensor has this mechanism where it incentivizes quality AI services. These incentives are called emissions, right? So every day, a certain amount of emissions get put out there for the subnets, AKA companies, to handle their everyday overhead, pay out their miners, whatever they may need to do to keep that subnet, AKA company, going. The whole new TaoFlow mechanism, what this does, just in my opinion, is it incentivizes subnets that have real utilities and use cases, subnets that generate revenue, subnets that maybe have a whale backing, right? And a lot of people maybe are interested in buying alpha in the token for various reasons, right? Because again, most of cryptocurrency anyway is based off speculation. And that's the problem, because there's going to be a lot of subnets that are doing the right thing, that actually have, you know, a good service, that are building out great technology, that maybe don't generate revenue. Maybe it's based off speculation. Maybe don't have a lot of inflows. And just because they don't, they will not be able to get a large chunk of those emissions. Some would say those subnets could possibly die. And a lot of people, you know, kind of feel like there's some good subnets that might, you know, become victim of the TaoFlow. But that's how business works, in my opinion. Businesses that generate the most revenue usually are the best businesses, right? Are the best investments in the stock. So this does is this really, you know, in my opinion, puts the hammer down and makes these subnets owners work for their emissions. This is the thing. If you do have a quality service, and you do have a clientele that's buying in, whether that's inflows, whether that's utilizing TAO and Alpha to communicate with your platform to use these services, if it's really good and a lot of people use it and you get a lot of inflows, you'll get even more emissions to build out and scale your subnet, aka startup. So, you know what I'm saying? There is pros and cons, but I'm not against or for either. I just wanted to explain this in a way that my community can understand. And that's how I look at it. You know, hey, you know, if you generate that revenue, if you have a lot of people that's interested in the alpha and inflow, and I think that this is important, right, for subnet owners in a way, right? There is a penalty for massive, you know, liquidations or sellings, right? So this also, TaoFlow also incentivizes holders to have diamond hand, versus outflows could be the make or break of how much emissions you get for your subnet to be able to scale. At the end of the day, if you do hold alpha and you are interested in this, in these subnets, and you do believe in what these subnet owners are doing, what TaoFlow does is incentivize holders to hold, because the more people that hold, the less outflows, the higher that score, the more emissions.
We're in it now.
Is it official?
The bear market is here.
We've crossed the line.
Down more than 20%.
This is classic bear market behavior.
Sentiment's flipped.
People are selling rallies now.
By every metric we track, the bear market is in.
It's here. The bear market. It's in.
Reduce the cost of virtually all goods and services. It'll make the United States a manufacturing superpower and the world capital of artificial intelligence and crypto.
Question everyone is asking.
Will the Fed keep printing?
Well, liquidity is coming. You can feel it building in markets.
The Fed's going to print.
They have no choice.
You open the spigot, the water's got to flow.
As soon as they blink, the floodgates open.
Liquidity is coming. It's just a matter of when you see it hit risk assets.
We're witnessing the start of that surge right now. The Fed's...
CZ said himself that AI and blockchain is about to rewrite the financial history, man. And it's crazy, because I know I was talking about the macro. I was talking about the liquidity and you know, even the, you know, this, the Secretary of Treasury is pushing these Fed cuts and things like that. But let's talk about technical analysis and what I see on the charts, right? Because we talked about things from a macro perspective, but let's talk about the charts. Now, the three charts that I am personally looking at is the Bittensor chart, of course, the TAO chart. You can see TAO here sitting around $292. It's holding that FVG gap. This is the fair value gap. This little white area here is our FVG gap, and it's been pretty solid as support. It seems like, you know, a lot of people bid right under 300 for TAO, so that's actually a good thing. But according to our indicator here, I would say that Bittensor is bearish under our ultimate RSI. Now, you know, we pay attention to higher lows and you know, higher highs and things like that. What I want to, you know, pay attention to is I like to draw these lines of support here on the ultimate RSI just to see how we reacted to them in the past. And in the past, you can see that we did use this line here as support and bounced off it. So this is the first time, though, we'll have to see if, you know, we can bounce back above this orange line being this deep. But depending on what Bitcoin and the, you know, altcoin market wants to do, macro, could really lead where Bittensor wants to go. The cool thing about TAO is that it's always one of the strongest tokens that bounce back, right? When you see Bitcoin or you see any type of altcoin rally, usually you see AI rally and you see Bittensor TAO rally. So that's actually a good thing. So technically, from a price perspective, we are lacking momentum. We are a bit bearish. You're looking at a bear cross here, and the moving averages are starting to trend to the downside. So I would say that this is bearish. We also broke a trend line. What needs to happen is we need to reclaim about $360. If we can turn $360 back into support, that's where the fun will happen. But if you believe that 2026 is going to be the year of liquidity, these are the best times to actually add to your bag, not financial advice. Another reason that I am still bullish on Bittensor is because the Bittensor dominance here is still bullish according to our ultimate RSI. It's above the orange line, which tells me mindshare sentiment. When altcoins rally, this ecosystem picks up a lot of liquidity. It has ETFs. Grayscale holds this. This is actually the biggest crypto holding inside within their AI fund. So that's actually bullish that, you know, these entities and, you know, huge companies and billion-dollar, you know, savants are interested in this ecosystem. And you can see here that the dominance is still bullish. So as long as we can hold the support here at these moving averages for the dominance, that's actually a bullish thing for Bittensor. And it tells me when the liquidity does enter the market, this is one of the tokens that will be bidded upon. Again, I also like the fact that we're still bullish here on the TAO BTC chart. We're looking at a little bit of a low there, which is bearish, but we're still above that orange line according to the ultimate RSI. Things could get a little rough here if Bitcoin goes down, because we are now utilizing the 21-day EMA here on the weekly as resistance. So we need to turn that back to support. So you can see how we got those mixed signals from a chart perspective. But again, in my opinion, the end and all be all is the liquidity. And according to historical data, when you look at that PMI chart, every time we were in an expansion state of the economy, we had an altcoin season. We haven't had that. We've been under 50 on the PMI for years. You feel me? So we've just been in an economy that's been contracting for years, and crypto has still been resilient. Bittensor TAO has still been resilient. So that's something to hold your head high for, that we did this with basically no real liquidity. And now the switch is about to get flipped on. So that's my outlook. As far as a price, you know, from a price perspective, momentum here, we're a little bit bearish on the momentum. We need to see more volume. We need to see more liquidity coming into crypto. But from a fundamental standpoint, nothing has changed about TAO. A halving is on the way, which could be ultra bullish or bearish, depending on your perspective. And I just think that it sits at a good spot being part of the artificial intelligence narrative. Anyway, guys, I'm going to get up out here as far as the charts. And, you know, like I said, you know, once that liquidity comes in and people really figure out what DTAO is and what some of these subnets are doing, man, it really makes me feel like we are extremely early. It's my words, but I ain't tripping. You ain't special. You the same as all the rest. Little bitch, she ain't no different. Always fading my new heart. Seeing like she bring prescriptions. That's my baby. Love my last bitch, cause I want her only nigga. That whole play, man, she get nasty in the backseat of the vehicle. She go crazy. Special switch from out the window of the rental. Please don't tell her. Hold the deuce, had shit to do, but now this trick got me too lazy. Like, I can't do it. I can't lie, I wanna die, but suicide, I just can't do it. Several times I put my thoughts to my mind, I just can't use. Anyway, let me know what you think about this current market. Are you bullish? Are you bearish? What do you think about the artificial intelligence sector? Do you think it's a bubble? And how do you feel about Bittensor, the new mechanism, TaoFlow, and the possible halving? Could it possibly cause a liquidity crisis for Bittensor and TAO? I would love to know your opinion. And if you are buying the dip, make sure you check out my crypto.com link. You can buy Bittensor right now if you use my crypto.com link and earn you some crow. It's your boy Crypto Millie. I'll see you in the next one.